Hey guys, it's Kim here. Welcome back to my channel. I am in Shibuya, the main hub of Tokyo, where everyone must go if you are traveling to Japan. I always get asked the question, where do I eat when I come to Japan? So I thought in today's video, I'm going to show you guys 9 restaurants in Shibuya Hikaria. So Hikaria is actually connected to all the train lines in Shibuya Station, so it's really convenient to get to. So it's easy if you want to go and meet friends. Now, of course, because I'm going to go to so many restaurants, I'm going to invite my friends to come along and try a bunch of different foods with me. So in Hikaria, there are restaurants that are amazing and they serve traditional Japanese food, which of course you must try if you are coming to Japan. So let's go into Shibuya Hikaria and let's eat. First, we are at Komeraku and they are known for ochazuke. Ochazuke is Japanese tea and dashi. They usually put it in rice, so it turns into a porridge. It's really good flavor. We're gonna get a teishoku, which is like a Japanese set menu. My first meal is 2 types of maguro, which is tuna. So what I'm going to do first is eat the tuna, a little bit of it first, and then I'm going to put the rice into this bowl and we're going to pour the soup into this bowl and it's going to change the flavor completely. We can also add some seaweed and katsuo to the soup. The seafood is so fresh. The tuna just melts in your mouth, it's so good. I really like the minced tuna, it's so soft and fluffy. So now we have our ochazuke. This just makes the flavor so good. So instead of just plain rice, the rice is now, it's flavored with dashi, which is stock, and it's so light. And also we can add the little popping bits in here to give it a little bit more texture. Next we are at Cafe Oba Canal, and this is a French-Japanese fusion restaurant. So for example, with the omurice, they do the omelette in like a souffle style. So that's really interesting. We're gonna also have some crepes. Let's go. So because we have so many restaurants to go to today, our first guest is Kanoko. Hi. And we're gonna have omurice and crepes.
Yeah.
The rice is actually more sticky.
Yeah.
It smells so good, I guess. Oh no.
Okay. So fluffy.
The egg is fluffier than usual. Oh, because it's souffle.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
That's
so good. And because of that, it's lighter than a normal omurice. A pudding. The egg, it's so soft. It's like a pudding. Yeah, I feel like I can definitely eat this whole thing.
Yeah.
So, okay, bye, Kanako.
Oishi.
This is amazing. But the rice is more dense and it's more sticky, which is, it works perfectly with this egg. So for dessert, we got a berry cream. Oh, that looks so good. Let's pour the maple syrup on.
I love crepes.
This tastes so different to the other crepes I've had in Japan. This is so good.
Now, this like this season, it has so many strawberries.
Oh yeah, strawberry season. That's true. The cream is really fresh and light.
Yeah.
That is amazing. But this is more of a French crepe rather than Japanese.
That's true.
But it's amazing. It's good.
You can finish all of it.
Oh yeah, I can finish all this.
That's more like gelato, isn't it?
It is.
It's gelato, right? Mm. It's not sorbet. I thought it was sorbet.
That's good.
Mmm. So creamy.
It is. Oishii.
Yum. So good. We're going to enjoy this. Right. It's amazing.
This is a place I really wanted to show you guys. So this is the 47 Chokudo. Now it kind of looks like a little grocery store, but it's actually a shop and a cafe. So the shop, it has a selection of different ingredients all over Japan, but then there's a cafe that showcases that. So we're gonna go in, have a look at the menu, and also this place, they like to showcase different prefectures around Japan. So let's see what we have. So the restaurant name is D47 Chokudo. So 47, the reason for that number is because there are 47 prefectures in Japan. And every month they showcase a different prefecture, so the menu changes. This time we are going to be eating food from Gifu Prefecture. So it's super exciting and it's cool that they showcase foods from all over Japan. So I mean, you're in Tokyo, but you can try food from different prefectures here. So this is the teishoku set menu, and it's from Gifu Prefecture. So we have chicken and ginger, which is so interesting because it's served on a leaf. And then we have rice, and also we've got, this is kind of like a seasoning that's made, well, they use ingredients from Gifu Prefecture, but they make it all here. And we've got some pickles, side dishes, which we eat with the rice as well. We've got a big bowl of miso soup, and it also comes with rice sake. It has 10% alcohol, but it's only just a little bit. So, oh, it smells really sweet. It's like amazake. This is sancho, Japanese pepper. So we're gonna put a little bit on. Just a little bit of that. The meat is so juicy. That's so good. The sauce they use, I feel like there's a lot of ginger and garlic in it, so it tastes, oh, it's amazing. It just kind of soothes your palate because of the Japanese pepper. I may put on a little bit too much, but it's actually really good. Mm. I'm gonna try some of this. This paste is kind of sweet, but it's really subtle, so it just kind of gives a little bit more flavor to the rice. We're gonna try the side dish as well with it. That's light. Mmm. This you can definitely taste the dashi. It's super light, also tastes very healthy. Tsukemono, which is the pickles. Oh, I like that one. This is a pickle and the flavor, it's sour, so it kind of reminds me of ume, which is a Japanese plum. I really like that flavor. Then we have the miso soup, and all the ingredients are from Gifu Prefecture. So compared to normal miso soup, there's a lot more ingredients in here. So we have radish, we've got root vegetables, carrots. Oh wow, that's so light. I feel like this miso soup is much more substantial than normal miso soups. Now we're going to try the drink. Oh, you can tell it is 10%. Sweet rice sake. Next we are at Fruits Palo, and because we are eating so much today, I have another special guest coming along. So this place is known for its fruit desserts. They've got cakes and parfaits, so let's go. So we have another special guest, Steph, and we're going to be eating our hearts away today. We've got this beautiful parfait. This is muscat, and what I like about this is that there's more fruits in this parfait. Usually it's just all cream, but it looks very fruity. Yeah. So I'm excited because it's got white strawberries at the top. I've never had a parfait like this before.
Is there ice cream in the middle? Is this cream?
It's a surprise.
Yeah, let's try.
Oh my god, I'm so excited.
White straw.
No!
Alright, let's eat.
Wow, it doesn't really taste like a strawberry. What? It's so much sweeter.
It's really sweet and it's really light, right?
Wow. I love white strawberries. They're usually so expensive.
Oh no, is it a cake? No, it's ice cream.
We got a fresh strawberry smoothie as well. Wow, that just tastes like straight up strawberry. Mm. That is so good.
You know?
Mm. Okay. It's like, it's just strawberry juice. Mm. It's so fresh.
I don't know if I've ever had strawberry juice before.
Me too. Flower shape. So much effort they put into the presentation here.
Mm. It could be like an eggshell too, huh?
Mm. I don't eat enough fruits in Japan, so
the fruits here are good. So expensive.
They are. And the fruits are so juicy.
Actually, I'm a sweet tooth, but when it's too sweet, I'm not a huge fan. Mm.
Next, we are at Mansaku, and this place is known for its local Miyazaki cuisine. Miyazaki is a prefecture in southern Japan, in Kyushu. We got some condiments to put into our sauces. So this is yuzu, like also yuzu kosho. Yeah. So it's
yuzu pepper.
I've never had this before.
Really? It's so good, yeah.
It's very, it's very citrusy. Yeah.
Citrusy and kind of peppery.
I'm trying all these like new Japanese sweets I haven't tried before. It's awesome.
Wow.
It looks so good.
I like that.
Creamy.
Mm-hmm. Mm. I thought the chicken was gonna be more crispy, but I like it though. It's like it's crispy, but it's not too crispy.
Mm-hmm.
And that means it's not as oily, so I can eat more. It's, when it's too oily, I can't eat too much. But this is good.
Nice balance.
Mm. I'm hungry now. I can actually I can eat a lot of that. That's perfect. So good. Let's try the shabu shabu. So this is not shabu shabu, but sero mushi. Sero mushi, which is it's actually vegetable steamed, and then you got the meat on top.
Oh, I love that.
Mm.
I actually ate my first.
I really like this. I'm gonna like just dig in here. And I've never had this before, and I feel like I found like my new favorite Japanese food.
Number.
I didn't know there were so many different ways to do this. That's gonna show us like a different way to do this.
Yeah, so now I'll just leave this and then add this on the top. Yeah, so then it becomes like richer, you see? And then you mix with shoyu after. And then like depending on how frothy you like your rice, you can just keep mixing it so there's little bubbles inside too.
Because I have an obsession with eggs. I eat eggs with everything.
Yeah.
And then I think that's also why I have high cholesterol. So when I did a blood test, the doctor said apparently my fiber is really good for a woman my age, but my cholesterol is high.
Yeah, maybe not too many eggs. Like one at one a day.
Yeah, like I'm obsessed. Oh, that's
see the difference in the color, right?
I just love eggs.
Me too.
They go well with everything. And I love raw egg.
Me too. So good. And Japan's the best.
Like a lot of people don't like to put raw eggs and stuff, but I don't know, just I feel like once you try it, it's so good. It's the easiest breakfast.
Yeah,
just
good.
Have like rice, egg,
and
that's
it.
And of course, if you're coming to Japan, you have to try sushi. So we are at Megumi, and their sushi is really reasonably priced. So let's go.
Yeah, that's the Akami.
Why is it so cheap?
Like, actually, yeah, that's
wait,
really
that's so cheap.
Though.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Oh,
look at these.
This is like a total of 3 times.
What?
Ube,
maguro, toro, zanmai. Oh, maguro, uni, gunkan.
Wow.
That seems
I'm
so good.
That's how cheap.
We got our sushi. I was so surprised. It's actually really affordable. This is like 649 yen.
This one was 1,188 yen. How amazing is that? I feel like for a place like this, having these prices, that's so affordable. Yeah. So we're gonna try. So we both got less rice because we've been eating so much today. So like ever since I've moved to Japan, I've been eating a lot more sushi and I really like tuna.
Just melts in your mouth.
We are now in front of Nurukan Sato, and this place is known for the oden, veggie kushi, and sake. So oden is a Japanese meal that is really light. It's a Japanese stew where they put in a bunch of vegetables, tofu, fish cakes, and then we've got the veggie kushi, which is pretty much a skewer, and they usually wrap the vegetables with bacon. So of course everything tastes great with bacon, so that's going to be exciting. And of course their sake is a large selection. I ordered some oden and veggie kushi. So oden is kind of like a Japanese stew. The broth is really light, made out of dashi, and they usually just have a bunch of ingredients just whirled into it. So it's really healthy and it's like the perfect meal for a cold day. Then I got some veggie kushi, and this is just pretty much usually vegetables on skewers, and some of it is wrapped in bacon. So I am so excited to try this. It smells so good. This is egg with pepper and bacon.
Itadakimasu.
That was a perfect temperature, because usually when I have veggie kushi, it's really piping hot, so it just burns your mouth, but this is just warm, so it's great. I can just eat this without any worries, especially tomatoes when they're piping hot or it's dangerous. So now I can just eat this without worry. The bacon definitely adds more flavor. I mean, look, everything tastes better with bacon, right? Just cheese wrapped in eggplant with pesto sauce. I love cheese. Next we have mushroom with mentaiko. Oh, that's spicy. Ooh. And the last one, I actually don't really know what this is, but let's just dig in and try. Chicken? Chicken with spring onions. Oh, that flavor is so good. It's a really strong salty flavor. Now we're gonna have the oden, and oden is actually one of my favorite comfort meals. I just love everything soupy, so let's just dig in. There's a bunch of different ingredients in here. We have the ribbon noodles. These are my favorite. We've also got some daikon, we've got meatballs, we've got some fish cakes and boiled eggs. Okay, let's go with the daikon first. The soup kind of reminds me of chicken stock, and it's really light. I feel like oden is something so simple, but it's so delicious. I'm having so many eggs today, but you know what? Eggs is life for me. I love eggs. Now this place is also known for their sake. As you can see, there's like a big sake wall just next to me. I got Rinko Pomu Pomu, and this is Japanese apple sake. Now this is from the Aomori prefecture. It's famous for the apples, so cheers. This tastes like juice. That's dangerous. It doesn't taste like alcohol. It's really sweet and smooth. Okay, look, I'm not a big alcohol drinker, but I could drink this. Okay, now I can feel the alcohol going down, but it doesn't taste like alcohol. Next, we're gonna go to Rikyu, and they are known for their beef. So we're going to get a Japanese lunch set menu, and you can actually upsize for free as well. Let's go. So I got a gyutan set menu. So gyutan is beef tongue. Now, okay, I know
For me, I'm very basic with my meal choices, but I tried beef tongue before I knew it was beef tongue at a Japanese barbecue restaurant, and I really liked it. If I knew it was beef tongue, I probably wouldn't have eaten it or tried it, but when I tried it, it was so good, so now I'm obsessed with it. So this, look at that. It looks so juicy. Oh my god, so good. That is amazing. It was chewy, but there was so much flavor in it. It was perfectly seasoned. That was so amazing. So I really like beef tongue just because, I don't know, I just really enjoy the texture. So if I, yeah, like I mentioned, if I knew this was beef tongue, I wouldn't have tried it before. But now that I've eaten beef tongue so many times, and this one is so good. It's fatty, but it doesn't feel oily. This one here is nanban miso, which is a pickled green pepper. And apparently it's really hot. So I don't think I've tried this before. So I'm gonna give it a shot. Maybe get a small one, just in case it's really hot. Just a little one. And it goes really well with the meat and rice, apparently. Let's try it with the rice first. It's not that spicy, actually. I mean, spice, okay, look, I like spicy food though, that's why. But it's not that spicy. Oh, it's got, okay, it's spicy, but it's a little sour. So it's like a green chili. Oh my god, it's so good. I love green chilies. Actually, in Japan, it's really rare to find spicy food. In a restaurant, it says it's really spicy. I'm like, I eat it and it's not spicy at all, but this does have a kick to it. You also get a soup with it. It's like a salty beef stock kind of flavor with a lot of onions added to it. So if you've never tried beef tongue before, I do recommend you come and just give it a shot, because this is really amazing. You have to try it. Restaurant is Somen So So So. Now I'm super excited to show you guys this because its concept is a chemistry lab. So if you look at the kitchen, you see test tubes and beakers everywhere, and they serve their drinks in beakers, which is really cute. Now what this place is famous for is somen. You can actually customize your meal, so you can choose your different bases and toppings to whatever you want. And somen, okay, it's like a Japanese noodle and it's really thin, so it should be really light. Now they have a Shibuya limited menu, which is what I want to try today because it's something special. So let's go. So for our final restaurant today, it's going to be really heavy. So I got Rocky to Hello. Join us today. So what did we order? We got
Home Napolitan.
Yeah.
And cheese kima curry.
Oh, so it's just like cheese.
Yeah.
And tomato sauce. It's kind of like Italian slash Japanese style. Mm. And look at the drinks. They're so cute and thickers. Yes. So this is, I just got like an apple juice and you got?
I got jasmine.
Jasmine, nice. Oh, that's good apple juice.
I drank maybe 100 milliliters.
You drank
now.
A little bit. That is awesome. I kind of want this.
Yeah.
I wonder if you can buy this. I used to do chemistry in university. I dropped out, it was really hard.
Sounds so difficult.
It was really hard. It was like, I was really good at chemistry in high school. And I was like, oh, it's going to be easy. I'm really good at it. Then in university, it was a different story. It was so hard.
How did you drop out?
Because I mixed, okay, I was in a lab. I mixed something together. I wasn't supposed to, but you know, I wasn't really good at it, clearly. I mixed two liquids together. The beaker for some reason turned black and it started vibrating. So I put it in a fume hood and I quit that day. I was like, nope, I'm done. I'm out. So I quit. Wow, that. It looks like natto and like toro toro.
Ah, so like cheese.
Honestly, it looks like toro toro. But it's cheese.
So natto mitai da ne.
It smells like spaghetti.
Like, spaghetti.
Because it's like meat sauce.
So, yeah. Because it's cheese.
Yeah.
Kima curry. Yeah.
All right. Let's try. Wait.
It's actually it's like really good.
It's curry. Okay. So it's kind of like a mix between curry and pasta. But with noodles but instead
so
of pasta.
Many. Yeah.
Yeah. I thought this is going to be really heavy because it's like a lot of cheese and curry. But
the noodles is somen, and somen noodles are very thin, so it's not heavy.
So,
the cheese is so unique though, like look at that, it just looks like toro-toro, don't you think? like natto toro-toro. Oh, yum. So this next one is an omu napolitan. Looks like there's an egg omelette at the bottom, and then you've got somen with tomato sauce. So let's try it, it's interesting. Oh wow.
So good.
I like that.
It's really good.
The sauce is really sour. The flavors work so well together.
Mm.
So the tomatoes make it really sour, but then the egg just balances it out. Oh my gosh, that is so, so good. That's so amazing. Good. I love this. I mean, I like everything with eggs. So.
That's great.
I was eating eggs all day. All right, we got forks.
Yeah, I'm Japanese and I'm very bad at using chopsticks.
Oh, it's much easier, right?
Actually, I'm bad at everything, like, in general, I guess.
No!
Oh my.
You can definitely taste more tomato in it.
So
good.
Very thick taste.
Yeah.
I love it. And you got bacon as well.
The bacon is so good.
Oh, so good.
We've been having a lot of bacon today.
Did you?
I like this one more than the other one, I think. I like this one so much. Amazing.
Yeah. If you're a cheese lover, maybe definitely that one.
I love cheese as well, but this work, I don't know why. Something about this, when I saw it, like, it just looks kind of like just noodles on egg. But it works really well. That is the end of today's video. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I am so full from eating all that amazing food. I found that all the restaurants were really different in their own way. So let me know down below what your favorite restaurant is and which one you want to go to the most. I will link all the information for all the restaurants down below, so make sure you guys check that out. Please thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.